My name is Evelyn and I work as a performance poet and I also write drama.
St Catherine's is the approved premises in Surrey and it provides accommodation mainly for men that have come out of prison on licence, is the bulk of our residents. But it provides a place for people that have been assessed as too high risk to be placed in the community immediately.
I've worked at St Cat's for about 2.5 weeks. So far I've had a couple of one-to-one sessions with three offenders. I use the same starter material. I think about themes such as, what do you want the courage to do? Has there been a time in your life where you've ever felt lost, angry, afraid? Might you want to write about that? You might not want to write about what you remember, but you might want to write about, what do you want the courage to do? What kind of man do you want to become? One of the offenders that I worked with, Colin, has a visual impairment. He has peripheral vision. When I first started to work with him, I realised that he couldn't actually read or write freely. So what I asked him to do was to speak to me. And he spoke about his life, and he spoke about what he'd done, he spoke about his future, and I noted down exactly his words. From his words, I created a poem. I'm learning to live with peripheral sight. It's hereditary. My dad had it. He's dead now. And my sister's got it. And I got it when I was 37. That's 13 to 14 years ago. Over time and time, it's just deterioration and deterioration. I went to hospital. They said I've got rapid deterioration, but I went to hear stable. It's scary. It's really scary. Over the last year, the eyes have gone rapid, rapid, rapid.
I've got into it and it's something that I've enjoyed doing. And it's showing you different ways that you can get things out of yourself to put down on paper with help, and it's good.
Jay is an offender who's worked with prose. He's written some stories in English and also English, Glasgow English, Scottish English. So he has a real sense of the language, a feel for the language already. He actually started off the sessions with choosing to write a poem on what he wanted the courage to do. And for him, it felt to me that that was a big step forward.
I want the courage to be able to express myself onto this page and be able to look back with imagination and understanding and to find a story that will rivet the senses, explode the mind. The writing will flow onto this page and be absorbed like a sponge and to illuminate.
He began to think about the world around him. He began to notice, for example, as he walked around, what he was thinking about, where might he put that down? He put it down in his writing journal. He found, in other words, a container to put his thoughts and his ideas and his feelings.
You need something to say, you know, you've got something to say or something on your mind. If you write it out on paper, you know, it sort of helps you. You know, I suppose similar to like talking it out with someone.
Tony is very interesting because he's already done some artwork, which is very profound. And the artwork itself reflects his changing states and his changing moods. So he already has a sense of presenting reality in different ways, of working with a different medium other than the pen. However, he found another route of expression when he picked up the pen.
Don't think about what you want to say, she said. Try to let the words flow, she said. But all my mind could do was wander back to that leaf. That leaf that was falling so, so late in winter, it was almost spring. What was it about that leaf I felt such affinity to? To me, it was the leaf that held onto its mother tree for so long, not wishing to be released from its sinews of connection. Then, when released, it danced on the air, trying to cling on to every draft, every puff of wind, fearing the contact with the ground would be its final act of life. Yes, I felt affinity to the leaf, and in seeing it struggle to survive, to retain some sort of existence, I began to cry. Yes, cry for a falling leaf. How poignant is that for that leaf, that it actually left something behind in its struggle to survive?
There's been times in his writing when he's, themes in his writing that he's explored, such as loss, and he's done that through reflecting the world and considering the world around him.
I think it's important to have projects like the creative writing because it provides an outlet for residents to kind of express themselves in a way that isn't too structured. You know, it's really about them and it's their kind of way of expressing themselves. It also helps to build up somebody's self-confidence.
We can step out of the shoes of constraint and begin to look at those things as in the mirror and begin perhaps to recognise their own responsibility and how they can begin to change and develop as a human being, that life is just not one way. There are several roads and many doors, and perhaps creativity and communication is a first step in a path in another direction.